Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, welcome. My name is Debs. So for today's video, I want to talk about the products that I've been loving this past month. So before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up, and now let's get into it. So the first product that I've been loving this month is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 Palette. So I finally picked this up a while back, and I'm so happy that I finally did. I think it took me so long because this palette has a lot of color, and I just wasn't sure how much use I would get out of it. I do have her first palette, her first collab with Morphe, which is a much more wearable palette with like more neutrals. And I have gotten so much use out of that. Show them side by side. So this is both of the palettes. So Volume 2 is obviously a lot brighter and has more color to it. So I wasn't sure if I would get as much use out of this one as I did the first one. Like I got this palette the day it came out. Like I still have the old version and it is like used and abused. But I've actually been really loving this. I've gotten a lot of use out of it already. I know that I'll get more use out of it in the summertime. So like these shades at the top here, like Love Handles, Perfectionist, Comfort Zone, even like Thick Skin, like they're such perfect neutral shades, like for those days where I don't feel like putting a ton of time into my makeup. I just want to like throw something in my crease and like be done with it. I've been loving those shades for that. And then like these brighter shades here, they look so intimidating. Like they're really bright when you're just like looking at them in the palette. But if you just use like a tiny amount on like a big fluffy brush and like kind of sheer it out, they're actually so wearable and beautiful, especially for like the spring and summer. And like this shade Therapy Sesh, this like lilac shade, oh, I'm obsessed with it. I've been using it a ton lately with like my purple looks, especially when my hair was more purple. And like, I'm just obsessed with it. This is such a beautiful palette and I'm so happy I finally picked it up. I wish I picked it up earlier, but like, I'm glad that I have it now. The formula that Jaclyn Hill has with Morphe, it's not their regular formula. She has her own and it is so much better than regular Morphe shadows. I'm honestly not a huge fan of the regular Morphe shadow. They're a little bit like patchy and dry, but Jaclyn Hill's formula with them is so, so good. So if you haven't tried these palettes and have been just like holding off, I highly recommend picking them up. They're even available at Sephora. Next product is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Hydrate Radiance Foundation. I think I've talked about this product probably like 300 times now, but I am so obsessed with this foundation. It is like, I think my favorite at the drugstore. The coverage of this is so amazing. Like it's definitely a full coverage foundation. This has the most beautiful finish and like almost gives your skin life. And this foundation I actually ordered. So I got it from Ulta, but through like a forwarding company because Ulta doesn't ship to Canada. And now like I don't know where to get this foundation in Canada. I mean, it's probably available on like Beauty Bay or something. I don't know. I don't know of anywhere where I can just like go in store and buy it here. So I'm like so scared to run out of this. It is such a good foundation. And I find that this holds up even if I'm like wearing a mask a lot at work and stuff. This is one of those foundations that doesn't transfer a ton. It just is like a beautiful foundation. I'm obsessed with it. You need to try it. If you haven't tried it, try it. The next product is the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Concealer. So I'm pleasantly surprised by this concealer. I honestly did not have high hopes for it. Another one of those products that took me so long to finally pick up. I had done so many ColourPop orders and just, I always skipped past it. I was like, I don't need it. I don't need another concealer. And I wasn't sure if I was gonna like it. A lot of people said like, it doesn't have a lot of coverage. It's just really, I mean, it's from their Pretty Fresh line. So it's kind of just like something lightweight and like for every day, which is fine. But like my everyday is full glam. So I've been pleasantly surprised with this concealer. It is super hydrating under the eyes. I have really dry under eyes. So I can't use like concealers like Tarte Shape Tape and stuff like that. Like I cannot use that under my eyes. It'll literally flake off. Love that this is super hydrating but also has a lot of coverage, which is hard to find in a concealer. And I have mine in the shade Light 40N and it is the perfect shade for me. So yeah, I've been loving this concealer and I'm really happy that I finally picked it up. Next up is the Beauty Bakery Flower Translucent Powder. So this is another one of those products that I picked up from Ulta through a forwarding company. I don't really know where in Canada we can get Beauty Bakery, but this was a product that had been on my wish list for so long, like literally years, I think. So when I was doing an order from Ulta, I was like, I need to pick this up. And then when I first got it, I didn't really use it that often. Like I used it just once in a while. But recently I've been trying to like reach for products that I don't use that often. So I've been starting to use this more now and I actually love it. It is like such a nice translucent powder. I honestly use this to set my entire face and I just take like a big fluffy brush, like dip it in there and just put the powder all over my face, and it works so well. It doesn't change the color of my foundation or anything, and it doesn't dry out my face. There's so many powders where like you set your face and your face just feels like tight, and this does not do that for me. It just has the most beautiful finish and keeps your makeup intact all day. So I really, really love this powder. And then next up is the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Bronze It Bronzer. So this is a older bronzer, but again, I've been trying to reach for products that I've had in my collection for a while that I kind of need to like use up or like try again. And like, not that I forgot about this bronzer or anything, because it has been one of my favorites since I bought it, but like, I just like fell in love with it. Like, this is the most beautiful bronzer. It has such a beautiful sheen to it. It's not glittery and it's not a matte bronzer by any means. It just has the most beautiful sheen to it and like gives your face such like a sun-kissed glow. It is so, so beautiful. And I feel like when this first came out, it was limited edition, because I know like when I got this like a few years back, it said it was limited edition, and then like I never saw it for like a long time. But now I see it everywhere again. It's like in stores, it's on Amazon, like it's everywhere. So I'm super happy about that. And I also love the pan size. Like, this is huge. Like, compared to the size of my hand, this is like a pretty big bronzer. Comes in a few shades. I have mine in the shade 01 light, so I think this is the lightest shade, but it comes in a few shades. And it's just so beautiful. If you have not tried this bronzer yet, I highly recommend trying it. I don't really hear anyone talking about it, but like the people that do talk about it are absolutely obsessed with it, just like I am. So definitely recommend checking this out. Next up is the Natasha Denona Bloom Highlighting Blush. So I actually won this blush in a giveaway a while back. And I'm so happy that I have this for the springtime. Honestly, looks a little bit intimidating in the pan. It looks like super bright and almost like glittery, but when you just like use a little bit of this and like just tap your brush in it lightly and put this on your cheeks, it blends into the skin so beautifully and just gives your cheeks like such a beautiful sheen, but it's not glittery or anything like that. And the color is definitely not this bright on your cheeks. It's just the most beautiful like peachy coral shade, and it's so beautiful for the spring. I'm so happy that I have this, because I don't think honestly I ever would have bought this. Like, it never intrigued me on the Sephora website or anything like that. But then the first time I tried this on my cheeks, I was like, this is the most beautiful blush. Like, how do more people not talk about this? It is just so pretty on the cheeks. So if you're like me and have just been looking past this, I highly recommend trying it out. This is actually the mini size. So they have a full size and then a mini available at Sephora. So definitely check out the mini one if you want to save some money and just try it out. It is like such a good blush. And then I want to talk about the ColourPop and Raw Beauty Christie collab, specifically this Super Shock shadow that they came out with. This one's in the shade Olympic. My dog's barking again. Please stop. I'm sorry about the barking in the background. So this is like the most beautiful shade. It's almost like a taupey, I don't know, a taupe champagne gold. Has the most beautiful like reflex to it. It is so, so pretty. I love just like throwing this all over my lid. I'm just so obsessed with it. This is another product that I got in the same giveaway as the Natasha Denona blush. I just got so many good products in there. This is so beautiful. If you love just like a neutral shadow to just throw all over your lid, this is for you. Like, I'm obsessed. Their whole collab, like the eyeshadow palette and the other Super Shock shadows, like they're just so beautiful. And then I want to talk about the Kylie Cosmetics lip liner. This is in the shade Bare. So I feel like the first time I tried this, I didn't love it. Like, it was just like, whatever. But recently I picked it up again and started using it more, and I'm actually like really impressed with it. So first of all, like, I love the color. It's such a beautiful nude shade. And like, I'm really impressed with the lasting power of this. I will say it's definitely a matte liner. It's not like, it kind of reminds me of like the ColourPop lip liners, but just more matte. That's what the shade looks like. It definitely doesn't dry out your lips or anything like that. And yeah, I just love how long this lasts. So many lip products just like fade away within like a few hours, but this one definitely lasts all day. So I definitely want to try out more lip products from her. I do have the Bare liquid lipstick as well, and like, it's fine. It just, it's kind of drying, and like, I'm not about drying lip products. Like, just not for me. I already have chapped lips all the time. Like, I don't need a dry liquid lipstick on top of that. And speaking of liquid lipsticks, the last product I want to talk about is the Jaclyn Cosmetics liquid lipsticks. So this one specifically is in the shade Ojai. It's like a light pinky nude. First of all, okay, let's talk about the packaging first. Like, it is so beautiful. It has like her name in a rose gold and then like a matte black ombre. Oh my gosh, it's so, so beautiful. This shade is just like a light pink nude. And like, I'm so obsessed with it. This is like my perfect nude lipstick. And these are not drying at all. They're actually like quite hydrating. And the lasting power of these as well, like they last all day. These are such good liquid lipsticks. I also got the shade Be Brave, which is more of like mauve shade, which I like as well. It's just a little bit darker. I like to use these together, like use this one first and then use this one more in just like the center of my lips. But yeah, I would highly recommend these. They are a little bit pricey. Like I think one is like $20, which is a little bit pricey, but honestly, I'm probably gonna pick up more and I really, really wanna pick up the lip liners. So next time I place an order, I'll probably pick up another lipstick and some lip liners if they're in stock. I hope they are. These are really good liquid lipsticks and they're hydrating. So if you suffer from chapped lips like I do and you need something hydrating, but you like the look of a liquid lipstick, definitely try these out. They are beautiful and there's so many like pretty nude shades. So there's a shade for everyone. So highly recommend checking these out. So those are all of my favorites for this month. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. And I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.